He's done it before.
I'd like to believe
to
that.
The monster hunter. Well, like, I would have to remind him since the last time in his quest for power he just went full on dick without thinking about it.
Oh, you mean like when we were sitting in Sylvanas and I was like,
yeah.
Hey, here's your dad's book. He died in horrible, inhuman agony.
Hey, guys.
Speak of the devil.
No way.
So, bad news is that I got a text that I have to get up early tomorrow. So, I definitely can't stay
early
for the entire time. I have to be there at 7?
So, you're waking up at what time?
Or wait.
Is that Ryan fainting from disbelief?
Yeah.
What? What?
Meet your shit,
sorry,
man.
I can't even hear everything. Sorry.
I heard you like bang a bunch of stuff up.
I have to wake up at 5. No, I have to wake up at like 4:40 in the morning, 5 o'clock.
I woke up at 5 a.m. today. I'm
That's
awake.
Because you're a dedicated swimmer.
Well,
and yeah. Go ahead.
I mean, you can't expect me to be held to your insane lack of sleep, Zuzu. That's just crazy. You don't get up
You're
at 4:40 in the morning.
Yeah, gotta swim at 5:30.
Well, that's not fucking annoying.
Yeah, but luckily I only do it once a week, so it's not too terrible. The rest of the week I wake up at 6:50, so it's not too terrible.
Still outrageous.
It's crazy.
So yes, I do agree on we shouldn't, stay up too late.
Well,
yeah, I can't. Unfortunately, I mean, I did, you know, I wanted to make this work, and I'm totally down for playing for, you know, as much as we can, but this is like, I'm in a hotel room with no computer, with a tablet and my phone to play. Like, that's what I've got. And
let's
just
do it.
My God, it's going to sound like Summoner Geeks inside of your room. Are there any women there?
Also, on the way here, I either had a very subtle prostitute proposition me, or I passed up on a girl who was flirting with me and wanted to get a drink. A very attractive
wow.
girl. I don't know which one it was. I either made a great call or really fucked up.
You might never know.
I'll almost for sure never know.
Giving you those herpy bedroom eyes.
Oh, lordy.
Herpy bedroom eyes?
What? I don't even... All right, then.
Those are the best bedroom eyes. I mean, come on.
Come hither and get her.
If you had to pick an STD.
I mean, yeah, seriously, if you do have to pick an STD, pick herpes, because like 80% of the world population has herpes.
Yep.
Yeah, because if you got the clap, someone would have to go up your dick with like steel wool, and no one wants that.
Which one is the clap?
That's chlamydia. Gonorrhea.
I think both chlamydia and gonorrhea
way.
Have been called that, but yeah.
Well, you need to get your core punched with gonorrhea, and I'd never want that.
Ugh. Core punch.
Something like that. It's like basically
God fucking
they shove
damn
a,
it.
They shove like a thing up your dick that is
okay.
All
right.
Blades and acid.
Good lord. We're taking this a little far, guys.
We passed a little far.
So there has been a few updates. I'll let you guys peruse those while Dahl tries to get his tablet working.
Who the hell is Alex the Raven?
Yeah, who's Alex the Raven? Who's Joseph Ecken?
You don't know them.
That's so Raven.
Okay.
Meta?
No, someone in the party knows them, but you don't.
Okay.
Erdana nearly froze Elethyss' face off. Did I miss something important?
Were you not there for that? I'm pretty sure you were there for that. Were you not there for that?
Was it the last, like, 15 minutes? Because I had to go at, like, midnight.
When we stopped at the lake before heading to Erganost.
Oh, yeah, no, I remember that now. It was a cold fireball.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, right, I was on vacation during that time. I was here there for the whole duration. Oh, God, I'm going to hate going back to work, especially because my boss is doing stupid things.
But I thought since there was a war on, I would make the world map a little more informative with regards to the status of the cities that you know. Based on what you've heard, yeah. So I put in status bars and then what I feel are fairly self-explanatory icons, like the skull and crossbones obviously means the city's been destroyed. The fist means that there's some kind of resistance going on. The boulder means it's under siege. You know, it seems kind of...
What about the little thief guy in Purisha?
Infiltration, because you know, the last time you were there, there was a Aetherian on a spike or a spire outside the gates.
Gotcha.
A dead Aetherian, I hope?
Yeah, because that was when the rogue... It was just after the rogue attacked you on the road. So you thought it was another rogue.
Long, long time ago. In a galaxy far, far away.
Well, that would be months back for us in-game. It's about, like, 2 months back for us in real life.
Yeah.
Okay, so if I recall, we had just gone shopping, and...
Yes, you had ripped off a poor, lowly shopkeep.
And got away with it.
And convinced Zuzu that nothing bad happened. And you were going to probably rest for the evening and then check in. Actually, I think Zuzu had something she wanted to do, and that's why she met up with you guys.
Yeah, I wanted to get get supplies to make crafting arrows with Dahl.
Okay. Well, if he crafts stuff in a city, it's kind of already assumed that he could find the materials he wants unless I specifically say otherwise, if it's something that doesn't make sense for him to have materials for.
Or we steal it from someone.
That's always another option.
Or convince them something else is super worth something. And then just sell that to them and use it to trade. We could do that.
Remember what
just
I
pulling
said?
Pulling examples out of my imagination here.
See, well, I have point. The... Darp.
Sorry, what?
Go ahead, Zip.
Oh, no. I was going to say, I have the finances to buy all the crafting materials, if we can find them. Sorry if that doesn't make any sense. Dahl, so I tried writing you a note in the note spots. I don't know. Listing out everything I wanted and then the total cost.
Okay.
In the chat, you mean?
I tried in the chat and I kind of failed, so.
No, I see. Yeah. It's up there on November 9th.
Okay. Half of it's like whispered, because I tried.
I'm on my phone right now. So, oh wait, the Steam community thing you sent?
No.
What is that? Who's Jonas?
Roll 20.
I'm not in Roll 20 yet. I'm still downloading the app.
Ah, I see.
That hotel no, Wi-Fi that though.
That message is me.
Okay. Is that to me?
No.
That is to you specifically. There's another one that was earlier before you got here. I just want to spam it again. You don't have to look at it since your hotel Wi-Fi is probably already screaming in pain.
Well, I'm on my 3G or my 4G on my phone because my hotel Wi-Fi. It's actually really good hotel Wi-Fi. I get up to 2 megabytes per second, which is fucking crazy.
That is what I pay for. That is what I pay for.
Up to 2?
Yeah, that's actually pretty nuts for a hotel.
Yeah, Darp, that's what I get, and I pay for 15.
Wow.
New York,
that's
yay.
Fucking sad.
You poor peons.
Fucking, I hate New York. Like, they've had the same infrastructure for internet since the fucking 80s.
Yeah, I get 60. Sorry.
Go fuck yourself. In every sense of the word. It took me, when World of Warcraft Cataclysm came out, DARP, it took me 3 days to download it. 3 fucking days, DARP. Do you have any idea what fucking little old me was doing that entire time? I was sitting there with my thumb up my ass going, boy, hope nobody fucking so much as tries to look up an email because I'll fucking get another day added onto this bitch.
You can't watch anything either.
Nope, couldn't even watch porn to pass the time.
Oh, you don't have a... You gotta have a private stash for those occasions, man. The internet goes out sometimes.
Yeah, dude. You gotta have your spank bank.
Yeah, of course.
That apocalypse spank bank. What of course. If the fucking world goes to shit?
Imagination.
You want to rub one out before you die. Alright, I'm looking through this app. So far, everything is fucked.
Oh dear. It sounded upbeat for a second.
It's coming through now.
So page changes will probably take you a little while to load.
I'll go sit in the group chat on the cell phone. Is that a bad idea?
Is he just holding down the mic now?
What? Can you hear that?
Yeah, it got stuck on, and I just heard you sitting there sadly in a hotel room, like.
What do you mean sadly? Not sadly.
I'd imagine right now it's very dark, and you're hunched over your phone, looking at it, like, come on, do the thing.
What do you do in a hotel room that you're imagining? This is how you're imagining me.
Sometimes it's I like to just sit on beds like, in hotel rooms like, and put my head in my hands.
I'm in a hotel room. I better turn all the lights out and just bend over my mobile device.
And sulk.
Hopelessly stare into the middle distance.
Yeah.
You guys don't do that?
No.
I can look at the journal.
Oh, right. I'm trying to look at the map. 2 megabytes per second. See the map.
Does it only show you the journal in the chat?
Says journal chat compendium and settings.
Oh crap. Try just going to roll 20. Try going into roll 20 in your browser. And just say screw the app because I think.
Is this flash based?
Because parts of it are. But they have it's mobile compatible because I pay for it. I think the app is intended for like. Sit down if you're going to be in person with a tablet.
Yeah, that makes sense.
But for everything that we're going to be doing in Erganost, it's not imperative that you have a map yet, so.
Would it be we'll possible?
Use the power of imagination, the best app ever invented.
That's right. And, I mean, if all else fails, we could have you just watch the Twitch stream and be a little behind. That would work, too.
Bro, I've got Minesweeper in my brain.
Oh, actually, I'm not apps. Streaming this one. I'm just straight recording. That's a problem. Okay. All right.
Isn't it because Twitch was being weird last time?
Yeah, it kept crashing on me.
But that was fun to string together.
I still haven't. I just transferred them all to YouTube, and yeah.
Yeah. So, would it be entirely possible to find more dried blood leaf to start making into more poison?
Yes. You can find somebody who sells herbs and Erganost for sure. But, unfortunately for you, you're a patient.
Right. Nobody wants to talk to me.
I'm just not sure that you feel well enough to leave, like, where you're... Yeah.
Well, it's not that I'm crippled. It's just I'm, you know...
Dying.
You know, it might make more sense
you don't know that.
To just kind of figure out all the details of me crafting shit when I have a computer.
That's fine.
Cool.
We can do that. Mm-hmm. Zuzu, you better have a notepad and write that down, what you want to do, because if you don't write it down...
What do you mean? I already wrote it down. Zuzu. I already have it written down, guys.
Yeah, but write down that it happened.
Oh, that he's going to craft them?
Write it again.
Okay.
Dear diary, today it happened.
Not like that would be vague and possibly threatening.
Okay, so you guys travel around town and you gather up materials for a very excited Zanthem who really likes to have special arrows, apparently. And I guess Savrik just stares at his shiny new toy. Actually. You bought a breastplate too, didn't you?
I got a breastplate and a fancy schmancy new sword. So Savrik is quite content.
Smiling more than normal. Which is never.
A very toothy smile.
Very creepy smile.
Toothy yellow-eyed smile.
Oh my.
It's the jaundice
staring at us all.
And in your travels, you... somebody give me a perception roll while you guys are roaming around during Mast.
I'm on entirely the wrong page. For some reason, is that for multiple rolls? The new tab.
Is there a new tab?
There's a new tab.
Oh wow, I haven't looked at it yet. Okay, Savrik is definitely completely entranced by his new stuff. I think Zanthem actually finds this. So Zanthem, you come across a red scroll case laying on the ground.
Ooh, and I pick it up.
Okay.
And proceed to read it.
It's a case, so you gotta open it.
Do you have to roll something to open it?
No, but I'm giving the other players a chance to do something about the fact that you're opening it.
I'm
slap
opening...
it out of her hand.
Let me check for traps. If it is a scroll
it's just
case,
sitting
I'd imagine
on the ground.
Kirrik, I'm sorry.
The rogue
but
is the one big.
Kirrik, you're not there.
Oh, wait,
cool.
Would Elethyss be there too?
Wait,
weren't
I'm sorry.
They together talking?
We all.
About...
Yeah, we all. Did. Are we the next morning?
No, not yet.
Not yet. Okay, then Kirrik is with us.
Oh, he is?
Well, I walked off with Elethyss to get that sidebar conversation with him.
Yeah, Zanthem and Kirrik joined us after he was done with the
Did. Okay, I remember now. All right, yeah. Go ahead and check it then.
Okay.
Well, I'm opening it, so you guys
want
to check it? No.
Oh, well, I thought you said you already opened it. I mean, like, yeah, hold on. I'll give it a once over.
I just...
Dangerous.
You don't see anything that seems like obvious trigger mechanisms, but you are concerned because it is adorned with symbols of Aetheria. It's got Iomide's sword and her shield and kind of a depiction of her running about.
So I should roll, some history.
How did you get this?
I just found it. I was walking along and saw it on the ground, and I'm the kind of person who just, I guess, wants to pick up things and give it a home.
Well, Aetheria hates magic, but just to be sure, I mean, we can sense magic on it.
Yeah, I'm going to cast Detect Magic, and...
Maybe it's like a dead drop.
And...
A bright
I doubt it's
red
magical,
dead drop
but
in the
let's
middle
find
of the
out.
Road.
Yeah. It's
you,
not the best.
You don't detect any magic. It's
I don't
very
think it's
inert.
Magical.
Okay.
Fuck it, do it up.
All right, I open it and show it to everyone.
Come to think of it, we probably shouldn't do this in the open, but oh well.
Too late.
Guys are all hovering over me and reading this. Ooh, this is fancy stuff.
Oh, propaganda. The war of the mind. I'd imagine we'd probably find a couple more of these scattered around if we wanted to look hard enough.
You might.
Well, this type of propaganda deserves to be brought to the head honcho's attention immediately so that they can round it up by themselves, because us looking around is not going to help anything.
dark addictions will be used against them. That is concerning.
They're going to use magic? The magic against us. Our magic That's... against us.
If this was supposed to be a private message, that is one really, really, really bad agent.
Yeah.
Well,
I say that aloud. Whoever dropped this is a terrible agent.
There's a couple people look at you kind of strangely when you say that, and then they see that you're holding something very red, and they move along hurriedly.
Great. Whatever, we're 5 Lycian soldiers. Weird looking ones to be sure, but... Not doing much of that lately. Kinda can't.
You might say that you're an odd looking duck.
Especially since he doesn't look like a duck at all.
What sort of bird does he resemble most closely?
Raven.
Like a raven?
He looks a bit like a raven with blue feathers.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's badass.
We had a depiction at one point that we were really happy with, and I don't know what happened to that.
Anyway, so, guys, do you agree with me that we should bring this to the captain's attention, or should we just, like, let it go and not care?
I agree. We should... I think we should let him know.
Yeah.
So, you just found this case. I just figured out how I can actually open up my character sheet and actually roll any abilities.
Cool.
So, did you roll spellcraft on it, Walker, and you just didn't sense any...
Yeah, there was no magic.
Okay. So what is the... So it's just an Aetherian suitcase?
So it's an Aetherian case. We opened it, and it had a scroll. I don't know if you read that scroll while it was up, but it says...
No, it doesn't pop
it
up.
It says, "Brothers and sisters of the pure flesh, repent now and you will be spared. Our war is not with you, but with those corrupted by the darkness. The tainted that you believe to be your friends deceive you. It is that they that bring death and destruction upon your lands and not the righteous armies of Iomide. We are here to liberate you from the oppressive control. They cannot resist the temptations of the dark magics. It is in their very bones, corrupting them from within. They cannot be trusted nor vindicated, and they all conspire to destroy our world. The goddess compels you to rid your land and your life of their evil ways. Soon we will use their dark addictions against them, and the glory of Iomide will be known to all. The sky will change, the earth will shake, and the unclean around you will riot and panic. Then shall be the time to strike. We are purity. We are peace. We are truth. Grand Hierophant Ishtif."
Oof, that was beautifully read.
So can I roll for craft toilet paper with that as an ingredient?
I suppose that would be a craft alchemy check.
I don't think the check should be too high. There's shit all over it already.
Well said. Well said. Anyways, so I was saying.
That's the best toilet paper anybody ever made.
Wow.
What the hell?
I just made the best fucking toilet paper in history with Aetherian.
As I see Cichael about to wipe his ass with this scroll, I say, wait.
I just made it into toilet paper. I didn't actually wipe my ass with it. Don't be crass.
Well, it's already a sheet of paper. How do you make it into toilet paper without wiping your ass with it?
Fair enough.
To make it crass, you just add ass.
I guess he just, like... changed its material properties, so now it's a much softer paper. It's more pleasant on the
bottom. Soft.
Yeah, it's like 4-ply.
Well, I carefully hold the letter and be like, before anyone shits on this shit, don't you think we should probably have this, or bring this to whoever's in charge here? That way they can deal with this propaganda. So we don't have to.
It concerns me that their forces have already made it to Erganost. The nearest army we know of is some 90 miles away. That's
here's my
disconcerting.
Question. Where did you find this Zanthem? Zanthem.
I was just on the ground, just looking around, observing, and
yeah. But while you guys were walking, she found it in the dirt. But you guys didn't really pay attention to the surroundings. If you'd like to, you can.
Yeah, I wanna yep. see if we can sleuth this shit out. I'm going fucking.
Is fucking the scroll case dirty?
Sherlock Holmes on
it. It does look like it's been laying here for a while. It looks sort of neglected.
I look around for clues.
It's hard to say if this was belonging to any particular set of footprints, because there's plenty of people that have been walking through here. And it's laying in front of just sort of, just like a bread shop. It doesn't seem to be very conspicuous. But you do look around, and you see a man holding one of these and reading it. And he just seems to be kind of scoffing at what he reads.
Just like laughing at it?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm going to go back up to that man and ask that man, where did you find this?
I just want to comment on the situation. I feel like my character would do this. What kind of Aetherian spy takes Aetherian propaganda around an Aetherian suitcase? It just seems extremely obvious.
They're actually scroll cases. Each scroll has its own individual case to protect the paper.
Oh, it wasn't a suitcase.
No.
Carry on.
Not gonna praise it.
So Elethyss, you approach this man, and he is kind of startled by you walking up to him. He says, it was just on the ground.
Does he point in any general direction of where on the ground he found the case?
He just sort of nods at the ground where he's standing.
Okay. Well, I look around and see if there might be other ones that we see laying on the ground anywhere.
You don't see any others, no.
Hmm. Well, I think I'm going to take this one to... What's the title of the person who's in charge here? Because I keep forgetting.
Chief. We're going to have to talk to the chief about this, you guys.
There isn't, like, General Vassir is in Sylvanost, and you guys are in Erganost. So, last time you guys just found a White Guard in the keep. I don't know that he had a name. Actually, you never asked.
It was just the White Guard.
The guy who gave us the, like, rendezvous and is controlling all the troops is just a guard?
That's
true, we actually didn't ask.
He's a captain. You never asked for his name.
Okay, well, he's a captain. I say that we bring this to the captain. I just want to know his rank. Like, that's what I would probably refer to him as, anyway.
I just want to call him.
You can call him the chief.
Call him chief. I don't care what you call him. I'm going to just bring this to
the
captain.
All right, we go back. I barge and I go, chief, we got to talk. New fucking shit has come to light. Oh, this sushi is delicious.
He walks up eating sushi to the guard. Like,
are you eating sushi off of the prostitute's body?
Body, oh my God, yeah.
She was fucking smoking.
Alright, so you guys head to the keep, and Cycle barges in all, like, excited that he has propaganda.
Question before we continue.
Go ahead.
Is that room that I'm going to be isolated in, is that in the keep?
No, you're actually closer to the barracks. One of the barracks has been converted into an infirmary.
I should probably head there.
Not feeling well?
On account of your dying.
I sneak away.
Okay.
Wait. Before you continue, I'm gonna notice. See if I notice him sneaking away.
You sure do.
And I just nod to him. I was like, "See you tomorrow."
I nod back.
Well, I roll also.
You do too.
Son of a bitch.
Okay. Bye. Are you gonna join us again later? Whisper. Maybe.
Literally, everyone sees you.
Told you I'm not a good rogue.
It's so rude.
You rolled a 23 stealth. Like, you did a really good stealth roll, and apparently all of us decided to actually pay attention to you. And everyone rolled like an 18 or 19.
Considering I have 11 points in stealth, no, that's not a good roll. That was a 12.
We're concerned for you.
Anyway, we continue on our business because I just nodded at him and said, "See you later."
All right. So the captain looks up at Cichael and says, "What do you mean?"
Listen, Chief. We just discovered some new evidence, and I smacked the scroll down on the table. And this one goes all the way to the top. All the way to the top. What's the deal with this?
The top of
you
what,
son? You brought me this scroll case?
I think what my friend means to say is that we found a box with this scroll in it. It seems to be a Aetherian propaganda. And another person nearby had also found a box with a scroll in it. I'm sure these are scattered about Erganost. And you might have a propaganda issue on your hand within the city.
That's what I meant. And I apologize.
We've found probably a half dozen of these already. Where did you find these?
We found it on the ground in an as yet undetermined locale.
In front of the bread
shop. I'm not hiding anything. Oh yeah, in front of the bookshop. Bread shop. I don't notice anything pretty much about my surroundings at any given time, so it's very difficult. I'm not trying to conceal anything. I'm just extremely uninformed. The bread shop. Okay, well, that was a cool talk.
Sorry, you just kind of caught me off guard a little bit there.
Okay.
Okay, so the kind of the more the business district. We found more of these in the civilian quarters. We're not sure who's been spreading them around, but we're going to take a survey of who has moved here recently with some of the new defending troops. It seems like we might have a spy on our hands.
Yeah, I would say so, or some kind of a propaganda person.
Or an espionage agent.
Someone trying to stir the pot.
Or an agent provocateur. Or a mole.
A femme fatale of sorts.
It's almost like you're using a bunch of different words for the word spy, which was already said.
I suspect the sword. A covert operative. Merchant,
a fly on the wall.
That we bought a sword from earlier.
A stick in the mud.
To swindle us in a very Aetherian way.
Oh my god.
In a very dwarfy Aetherian way.
Are you implicating the dwarf? Like, do you say that?
I whispered that kind of to my compatriots, and I just go, no. Even that would be too evil for my true neutral. But it would be hilarious if we stole from and then kind of imprisoned as a spy. I think my real reason for not doing it, I open up my mouth and go, well, and then I go, oh. But then if you arrest him, you'll think that you caught the spy and the real one will still be out there. No, in that case, no. No, I'm not actually implicating him.
All right.
That and the waste of time could compromise the town even more.
It's true, but the laws would be very worth it. Sabre.
I've never wanted to get in the way of anybody's laws, so... Carry on.
I would be.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So the captain thanks you for bringing the scroll to his attention, and he says that you should probably get some rest, and that Nonek Lightborn will require the assistance of Elethyss in the morning to treat Kirrik.
Is there something? And this is a meta. Is there? I need to come up with like a character voice for my character, so I don't have to say that every time. Is there something I could do to like to detect like who might have created a scroll or something like that?
You can use linguistics to like compare penmanship if you find a handwriting example.
Oh, I see. Okay, that's good to know. Do you have any suspects, Captain? Chief? You got any suspects about this spy case?
At the current time, no, but I suspect that we'll have one by the end of the week.
You suspect you'll have one?
I will remind you guys that we had decided that tomorrow we were planning on setting off to go try to recruit the monster hunters.
Yep.
And in 3 days' time, we were supposed to meet at the rendezvous point, if possible. Which is unlikely.
In a week, then.
So by the end of the time we meet at the rendezvous point, they will have discovered, hopefully, who the spy is. In all likelihood, that would be the time frame. But that would be.
I don't want him to discover who it is. I want him to have a suspect, a group of suspects.
Well, that's what I meant. Is like. A week time would be like after we went to the Monster Hunter stand, met at the rendezvous point, and helped OnStar. And
I say when you put out this census asking for people to say whether or not they're new to the city, could you keep pieces of their handwriting so that I can later come back here and compare it, and maybe that way we'll figure out who our traitor is.
He seems interested in the fact that you seem to have skills to solve this, and he says you're a linguist?
I am. I am a linguist.
He's a pretty smart guy.
You're the one that speaks 23 languages, correct?
No.
Is that someone else?
No,
never mind.
I speak like six or something like that. Like
okay.
Which is impressive.
Yeah.
Still pretty good. Yes, I'm a very cunning linguist, as they say.
Oh wow.
Saverick chuckles at that.
I blush.
Wow. The captain says we can absolutely do that. We will keep handwriting samples. We'll get handwriting samples from everyone because we weren't planning on doing that originally. It's just a head count to get a feel for who came from where. We figured we could probably narrow it down that way, but the handwriting is good because it would narrow down the pool significantly.
I agree. Until next week then, Chief.
Agreed. They won't be able to do too much damage.
Good. Okay.
The only thing I'm worried about is that if they're spreading it here, where else they might be spreading these things, because OnStar actually has a chapel to Iamide. They're more moderate than their Aetherian cousins, but if the right words have been said, it could sway opinion.
That's a good
that
point. We'll
is
have to
a good
keep
point,
that in mind
but
when we invade the city and kill every single last Aetherian in a really, really evil, painful, just shamefully, shamefully brutal
way.
Let's not get too extremist, son. Then we'd be no better than they are.
Exactly. Well said, I'm, Captain. Chief?
I'm totally not better.
Regardless of whatever the situation is, there's nothing that we can do right now about any situation elsewhere. All we can do is look for the suspect here. But we should be getting rest.
Shall we go? Yeah, let's go. We're going to go rest now, Chief.
Very well. Good luck on your journey tomorrow.
On our way back to the barracks,
thank you,
where we'll be spending the night, I talk to everyone and be like, okay, so we should probably get to the monster hunters as quickly as possible so that we can ask for their help. And since Saverick is with us now, I ask Saverick if he thinks that he might be able to assist us in getting their assistance. Help us get help from them.
Redundancy.
I possibly the promises that Kirrik and Zanthem's the suggestions she made are give me some more hope, but it's going to be a tough sell.
I do understand that.
What could make it a softer cell? Would maybe some baby soft 3-ply Aetherian teepee?
And a draining tub.
And a draining tub.
I don't think that's a draining tub, but
guarantees of protection for non-humans, stronger treaties. Really anything.
Sweet. They have low standards then.
Position is very precarious.
Understood. I'm sure that with your assistance, our friendly gang might be able to at least persuade them to help us in OnStar or help defeat the monsters at Bafok's Lair. Perhaps.
Selling them on that will probably be our best option.
No,
they'll want coin regardless of an agreement,
I'm sure they'll be paid appropriately.
Yes. But I don't know. We'll have to see. Joseph will definitely want something more than lip service from the leadership.
That's understood. Perhaps there'll be something that we can do for them as well. We are seemingly growing more powerful with as time passes.
Yes.
Granted, we can't speak for the country, but we might be able to do something else for them. In any case,
you're the children of some of the leaders, so your words carry weight.
We hope so. With Kirrik's condition the way it is, and me helping Nonek tomorrow, I don't know how long it will be before we can help Kirrik recover fully. Jamash should recover fine, Cichael, but Kirrik's condition might be a little bit more precarious. So I might suggest that you guys continue on to the Monster Hunters.
You are not a sworn doctor. That's... Damn it.
Well, I was told that I have to help Nonek, so I'm just saying that, like, I don't know what's in store for me. So, might stay longer with Kirrik to help him get better. If you guys want to go see the Monster Hunters without us, and we can catch up if he recovers well. And if not, then...
He's actually... You're sitting down to treat him that night before you leave.
I thought it was in the morning.
I have to give one of you folks my handy haversack. So when he comes, I'm going to give him that, and I guess he'll have to decide who gets it, because it's got the hide your head in it.
Yeah.
And that's going to be a very important thing for bartering.
Yes.
I'll take that responsibility.
So, wait. Chris, I'm confused. So,
sure, what's up?
So Nonek needs me that night to help treat Kirrik, or...
Yeah, we'll treat it that way, because you're going to be leaving that morning anyway, and I hadn't intended for you to feel pressured to split up from the group.
Okay.
So, that evening when you meet up
Never
with
mind,
Nonek...
Never mind, ignore that conversation.
That evening when you meet up with Nonek, he tells you that with your like restoration spells and some of the magics that he is aware of, he believes that they can stave off any effects that will occur to Kirrik, but he believes that he would need a more powerful druid in order to cure him completely.
When you say more powerful druid, are you saying that I need to go find some of my people, or some of the druids that haven't existed for thousands of years?
Let me see.
Or that I need
how
to get more
How would
powerful.
He word this? He would say, no, clearly you wouldn't go and find the people who have been deceased, we would wait until you are stronger, and we would just stave off the disease until we're able to cure it.
Okay.
Could we do some sort of isolation thing where you just restrain this one, like pinky toe? Like
a blood transfusion.
You're breaking up really bad.
Yeah, sorry. Actually, one of the other things that Nonek mentions as an option is if you could get a transfusion of Tiefling blood. Or not Tiefling, but damn it, what is your race, Kirrik?
That would be Tengu. Original race or Tengu?
Tengu. If you could get a transfusion of Tengu blood along with your magics, he believes that would be enough.
Okay, so I either need to become more powerful or get some Tengu blood.
Yes.
Okay.
Easier said than done.
Yes, since we've never encountered a Tengu other than you.
There are some Tengu that live with the islanders to the west.
I look off to the west. The islanders, as in where?
Off the coast of Lacia. The westernmost coast.
That's a long ass way away.
Yes, it is.
That'll be rough.
Why can't you do his own transfusion? Because don't you create new blood all the time with your heart?
No, that's not how that works.
Okay.
You create new blood with your bones. Fun.
Okay.
Also, if he's, you know, diseased with a like sickness that is changing his body, then his own blood wouldn't cure him.
So we pull his bones out of his body, let them make blood, pump it back into his skin sack.
Sorry to say, Saverick, okay. I think the bones are infected too.
What about Zyrul? Wasn't that his name, your friend?
Well, we had arrived in this town this night, and like in the morning, the letter is going to be sent to Zyrul asking for help.
Yeah.
So it hasn't even gone out yet. So I asked Nonek how long would our combined magics allow us to stave off the ill effects on Kirrik? Like, how often would we need to repeat this process until I'm more powerful enough to cure him?
Well, that's difficult to say without observing the symptoms progressing. I would say we should probably shoot for once every couple weeks, unless we see a reason to make it more often.
Okay.
Well, as we already know, there's probably going to be some form of atrophy, but everything beyond that, as he said, we have no idea, but I don't think even your registration magic is going to stop the change.
Well, I mean, if we stave off the effects for a certain period of time, then we'll find out. But I look at Kirrik, and I stare at him incredibly intently.
Does let you know the combination of magic he believes is necessary is a combination of lesser restoration, remove disease, and resurrection. Or more specifically, reincarnation.
Okay. So I'm looking intently at Kirrik, and I ask him this question as straight-faced as possible. If your condition changes, are you going to tell me, or are you going to lie about it?
I lied about it because I didn't want to hurt the party. Or not hurt the party, worry the party. Now that we're here, I have no reason to lie.
Very well.
But
that was not a bluff.
That was excellently played.
In that case, shall we begin, Nonek?
Yes. You both, Nonek instructs Kirrik to lay down on the table, and you both stand over him, saying your various incantations for several hours.
You hear screaming in the distance, everyone else.
No, Kirrik, you don't really feel much different. In fact, it's kind of a boring experience for you, other than, you know, faint glow from the druid and Nonek.
Screams of boredom.
Yeah.
Groans of...
Ah!
I mean, you might just fall asleep. I don't know.
I could draw.
Just in there doodling. Are you guys done yet?
Say what? All right.
So you guys finish your procedure, and Nonek seems pretty pleased with the results. Kirrik, you feel like the crawling sensation just cease completely, but you still feel the bald spot, and there's still the black flesh around your wound, but it looks less serious now.
Neat.
Cool. This is good. We have good news to tell our friends. And I escort Kirrik back to the bunker.
You should probably honestly stay here in case anything happens.
Very well.
Yeah.
I will tell them the good news myself. I walk off to the bunker.
Oh, you have my handy haversack with you, right?
Yes. I don't know what's in it, so...
I could link it to you, but there's a lot of things. Just, I'll be here. Just ask me. Or have Darp look at it. There's a huge list.
Are you staying in Erganost?
I imagine it would probably be best.
You should come with us.
You should go with.
Alright.
Nonek's pretty confident you'll be okay for at least a week.
You're not dead yet.
I'm not dead yet.
It's not that I'm not dead. It's that, you know, the last time we tried to take a shortcut through somewhere, I nearly drowned in mud.
Well, if that's an excuse, you should have stayed in Myra.
Oh my god.
I could have hid.
Yeah.
The town is burned to the ground. I don't think you would have done much better there.
Yeah, as far as you know, the town is burned to the ground. You've never been there since it happened.
We were told that the cities were ransacked.
Actually, you just saw fire and smoke in the distance, and you know that a bunch of buildings were razed, but you don't know that if it was totally destroyed.
Very well. Okay, so back to the bunker. I have the handy haversack.
Oh, I mean, if I'm coming with, I might as well just have it.
Yeah, you should probably just have it. You're coming with. You're fine now. You're fine. You hear me? I keep trying to boost his confidence. If there's something that I can roll, just like a confidence booster, that would be, I guess. Here we go. I'm going to perform.
Compliment his dick.
Confidence booster.
Perform confidence boost.
Yep. Excellent. Your confidence is boosted. I win.
I mean, I guess so.
I'm laughing pretty bad at this. Anyways. Guys, guess what? Me and Nonek we didn't quite save him. He still has the disease, but me and Nonek have contained it, more or less. So he should be fine for at least a week. Maybe two, maybe three.
Yay! Mom will be pleased.
But we should definitely sleep, because it's probably the middle of the fucking night and we have to leave in the morning.
Yeah, it's probably like 11:30 at this point. It's pretty late in the evening.
It would probably be way later than that, since we arrived after 8 hours of walking, after 10 hours of walking that day.
Oh shit, yeah, you're right. Well, but then you rested, though, in the tavern, right? With the random guy.
And then we went shopping.
I don't remember that.
Wait, I might be conflating games. Yeah, I think I just mixed games together.
It's been a long ass day. Let's just say that. It's like 12:30 and we need to sleep so that we can leave in the morning.
That might be wrong, but I'm not saying my character didn't sleep with a random guy.
In a tavern.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
We did sleep with Tim. Technically.
I'm pretty sure I made Tim shit himself too.
Hot pockets are done.
I think we all made him shit himself.
Okie dokie. So you guys rest, and obviously it's fairly uneventful. you don't hear much of anything outside. It's really quite quiet tonight. And it's this morning.
Oh, dog. I kind of want to, during the nighttime, I kind of want to, maybe like look out the window and see if we can find this propaganda person. It's like taking a look and see if somebody's out there spreading some shit.
Okay.
But we don't have to do that.
No, that's fine. So I would say that you wake up probably in the... Actually, give me a perception roll for that. What time of day do you kind of wake up and check the window?
Let's say 2 a.m.
Okay.
I wake up and check the window. My polypropers pinch here. Probably wears off a little bit, and I wake up to take a leak before I go
of
back
course.
To bed. Shit.
You watch out the window for maybe, 15 minutes or so, because you're kind of paranoid. And you think you see, the shadow of somebody moving around out there, but you're not completely sure.
That's fair.
It could just as easily be like a raccoon or something.
Moving on. I saw a raccoon in the middle of the night and I go, oh, that was weird. But I don't really think anything particularly of it. And I go take a leak and go back to bed.
All right.
Out the same window.
Oh, cool. So spellcraft is something you would use on an instance of a spell being cast at that time, right? But arcana is what you would use for something like an object you found. Well, I want to see if there's anything on there, so I'm going to use Arcana. And I didn't use Spellcraft before, FYI. Mm-hmm. I'm sipping my coffee. I feel like there's more I could do here. I feel like I could look at the linguistics to see what language this is written in, and if so, maybe if the sentence structure gives away. Though I guess we know it's from an Aetherian person. That's probably not really telling us much. Yeah, don't go too far with it. No, I just don't want you to give it to me too far. I mean, I don't want to.
Oh, yeah.
What other thing I don't want to push at locked doors in the sense that, I don't want to try to
it
create.
It just keeps getting better.
Well, I don't want to try to create roleplay content where none exists or it's a totally undone thing. Fair enough. Okay.
If you think of detectivity stuff that you might want to do to it, then you can just bring it up. Because, it's assumed that while we're traveling, you might just occasionally stare at the scroll and start investigating it. Okay.
Yeah.
Since we have a copy.
I'm going to consider other things I might be able to do to this.
Is there a spell of some kind that lets you see who has handled something or track where it's been?
I know that I don't have one, but one may exist.
It doesn't sound like anything that would be on my spell list at all, so.
Yeah.
Maybe you could turn into a bloodhound and then sniff down the person.
Oh, I like that idea.
That's pretty good.
Thank you.
I already did a perception on it, right? Or did I? Yeah. Okay. Well, before I do that, I want to particularly look at the writing and see if I could tell. I guess I wouldn't be able to tell anything from what kind of hand it is, but maybe there's like an ink smudge. It's like a fingerprint. That seems too convenient. Shit.
Not to mention, like, how would you compare fingerprints unless we had all the information from the military right, that they're collecting yeah. as we speak?
Yep.
Right.
You'd also have to invent fingerprinting.
I mean, that's totally doable. We can move on for now. If I think of something later, we'll try it.
It's probably on, nice Blanche. Being out of the swamp where it's, you know, rotting his hooves.
I pet Blanche, and I'm like, there's
hair. You do, doing a good job.
Who's ready to work?
No, Blanche, don't be mean. Awesome. Well, we also hadn't, like, me and Cichael had discovered that, like, we could take the road, because we knew of this road here, like, the one that's perpendicular to the other one, and we know that that's the one that the monster hunters typically take, and there's a castle along it. And then we also know that this short path is generally pretty safe and on flat grounds, but we haven't asked Savrik how he would go, because, you know, it's kind of, you know, where he's...
It's true. Savrik, how do we get there?
Quickest way possible.
I usually prefer to travel by road. But what would I know to be the better way? Mm-hmm. Or do I need to prompt an intelligence check?
Roll detect memory.
I know that I tend to stick to roads.
Okay,
let's go to the roads then. But won't you be more easily found? I thought they want to be kept hidden and stuff like that, so roads would be kind of easy to spot.
Well, we know that they take, like, the route we were told is that they take this road, and they take this road, and along the second road, they have a castle that they sometimes inhabit. It's not like they're hiding, it's just that they live off in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah.
Yeah, and the blue line is literally a path through grasslands.
It's a dirt path as opposed to a slightly larger dirt path. Really? Okay.
Moderately well maintained.
Yeah, I say we.
So it's like an old country road versus a new country road. It's a lot of cobbles. My sense is that we're less likely to run into delays if we travel along the roads.
Okay, sounds good enough to me.
So we set off on our way along the road.
People are there a pretty good deterrent to a lot of wildlife that we might run into along the plains.
Just disappointed.
what roads the wildlife to turn druid. As a deterrent to all the people we might run into.
Psycho antisocial now.
Run into people.
Yeah.
While I can control the wild, I can only control them for so much. It's probably better to travel along the road.
I feel like Kirrik doesn't care.
Meta, is our travel faster along a road than it is over land?
Yeah, when you guys were traveling through the swamps, you were moving at like 15 to 20. On roads, you can move 25.
Cool.
So you set off on your travels for the first day. The skies are fairly clear, but there is some cloud cover moving in. Elethyss knows from experience and from paying attention that you guys are entering the rainier season and can probably expect more frequent storms. But beyond that, you don't encounter anyone on your travels, and the roads fare you pretty well. About 4 o'clock or so, there starts to be some rain. Rain! Okay.
Cool.
It's a free shower, everybody.
And then the sun sets. And you, I guess, try to find a campsite.
Okay, sorry, I'm being annoyed by the moon, so give me a minute.
You can't see the moon, there's clouds.
Shut up. He's annoying me enough, I don't need you to.
You put in the wrong moon?
Okay,
friend.
I'm looking for a place to camp.
Are you saying the moon is annoying you? Is that the moon from the Mighty Boosh?
No.
The moon
is a person.
Roommate and friend.
Oh. They said the moon.
The owner of this Mumble channel.
Yep. Technically.
Yeah. Technically?
Yeah.
Has anyone ever seen the Mighty Boosh?
Nope.
Yep. Nope. No idea what you're talking about.
Nobody's seen it but you.
Old Greg.
I'm old Greg.
If you've seen old Greg, you've seen the Mighty Boosh.
Oh, okay, yeah, I've seen that.
It was the Mighty Boosh, but yeah.
At the beginning and end of episodes, they slather whipped cream all over the like pretty boy's face, and he pretends to be the moon. He's like, and so the day ended.
Oh my.
Yeah.
It's weird.
That whole thing is pretty weird. I mean,
yeah. Oh, I'm gonna come inside you.
Eels.
I'm gonna come inside you like a warm kitten.
Wow.
Yeah. You ever drink
I mayonnaise? Still need to show Zuzu those, actually, because those are freaking disturbing.
Don't watch them, Zuzu.
No, that's salad fingers.
The crack fox.
It's the fucking worst.
Every one of them is the worst. They're all fucking atrociously disturbing.
I'm gonna hurt you real bad if we get inside.
Okay.
What? Nothing!
Anyways,
just a funny sound.
So sorry. I'm guessing I find an awesome place to camp.
Yeah, with a 33, definitely. You find yourself a nice little dry hill. But
even though it's raining.
Yeah, it is raining, but I mean the hill doesn't have any standing water on it.
Cool. Well, I'm gonna set up camp stuff by casting hide campsite. Are there any trees on this hill or anything, or is it just like?
No. It's...
Is Erdana with us, by the way?
I think she was going to stay and go with them.
She's staying in Erganost, yeah.
Okay.
Good question. I totes forgot that.
Wait, why did she stay in Erganost?
She has anger issues.
She's pretty distraught about her sister.
Right.
If you recall, she was like super fucked up and went off on her own and... kind of went crazy.
Right, what I was thinking in my head was, she'd want to come with us because we're going to go liberate her eventually, and then I realized, oh no, she knows we're coming back, so she'll just probably hang with us.
She's probably
going to
stay up on a wall and throw fireballs at Aetherians for a while.
Release her anger.
Actually, right now, she's just trying to get her head straight. She's pretty fucked right now.
Gain the magic ability to talk. Also, learn horrible, horrible future about your sister. Also, be unable to save your sister. Also, assume the worst about your sister.
Yeah.
Also, nobody seems to care about your sister but you.
And me.
Yeah, she likes... She's pretty fond of Kirrik now. He's grown on her.
Your previous mortal enemy is now the closest thing you have to a friend.
She's not a mortal enemy.
She hated your guts.
She just tried to keep her distance, really. She doesn't like attachment.
Understandable. Now she's lost her sister.
Yeah, and that, yeah, this has made it even worse, definitely.
Rebound!
You're gonna be her rebound brother.
Oh my god. So I hear you need a sibling.
Yeah, in all fairness, like, you have a crush on her sister, and yes, they're twins, but that's horrible of you.
They're twins in the sense that they were born in the same time from a tree, but like...
Why not both got JPEG?
Yep.
Oh.
I can tell the difference.
Anyways.
So...
So to answer your question, as it happens, there is a single tree, but it is not very large. You don't think it'd be big enough to provide cover from the storm.
Elethyss,
might I tell you that you have that token that spawns a 40-foot tree?
I'm not going to waste that token, because it's raining on a hilltop. When we have a covered wagon that we could all sleep
we'll
in.
We'll just call it Lone Tree Hill.
Oh my god.
There's already a tree on the hill. It would be too...
We'll kick over that tree and put that in its place.
Lone Trees Hill.
It should be the Watership Down tree.
Twin Pines.
They'll call it the Twins.
The Twin Pines, perhaps. And they might put a mall here at some point.
What's a mall?
Anyways,
it's a big hammer.
To cast Wood Shape on the tree.
Okay.
And change it to provide a little bit of shelter. So that we have at least room for the fire.
So
the fire doesn't go out.
You wood shape the tree and you form it so that basically all the branches are leaning over to one side type of thing.
Yes, a little bit of cover.
Okay. You provide sufficient cover to create a space where there isn't like rain coming through rapidly.
Occasional drip is okay.
Yeah. So, but the challenge you might have is finding dry firewood.
Well,
it sure be nice to have Ardana to make us a fire.
Well, I mean, lots of people can make fire.
Oh, but you can make it out of your hand.
I can also make fire if we have dry firewood.
Yeah.
The thing is finding dry firewood. Well, let's look around for firewood.
I'm sure the alchemist could just make an alchemist fire potion.
33 survival.
It's not actual fire.
Again.
I don't think. And that also, yeah, it wouldn't create...
Actually, that might work. Let me check.
Could I?
For what?
Alchemist's fire?
I just put the cauldron down and just, like, mixed up, like... Basically, like, a torch. Like a...
True. Like we can just...
What is that little...
We can put the cauldron down.
What are those canisters you put down?
And have it make boiling water.
Yeah.
Alchemist's fire.
Like, those little torch thingies or whatever.
It does take... Things do burn after a round of being hit by it, so...
So, is the theory then that it's like a lighter fluid, and you would use it to dry firewood? I kind of like that.
Yeah. I like it.
Yeah, I dig that.
So, Cichael dries some wood with his alchemist fire, and then I spark it up.
So I use the cauldron to create like a little running torch thing to dry it out.
There is actually an oil called Alchemist's Fire that you can make.
It can be like turned into a bomb, but targets that get hit by it burn afterwards. So we figure it could just be used to dry out firewood and then just start it up.
It can also be used as a component to increase the power of spells, which is pretty cool.
Neat.
Increase the power of spells?
Yeah, like Fireball or Burning Hands or Flaming Sphere.
Oh, shit, dog.
Cool. Well, if he's going to do that...
I wish we had a sorcerer in the party or a wizard.
I will spark up whatever he makes. I need to use the restroom, so I'm going to roll my perception for when we're sleeping.
Okay.
I do cast hide campsite on him.
He sparks up the firewood, I spark up a big old cigarette.
And I'll be right back.
Oh, Dahl, while we do this part, have you been watching Rick and Morty this season?
Oh, yeah, dude.
Fucking season 3 cannot come fast enough.
Oh, it's going to be a long time. Year and a half at least. Ooh-wee.
I know. Hey, Morty, you want to purge these guys? I mean, it's totally justified. I mean, they're asking for it. He's like blowing holes in people and shit.
Saving a little girl, Morty, is literally anything we can do is morally justified.
Fucking Amish bitch shot me. She shot me in the liver, Morty. It's the hardest working liver in the galaxy, and she put a hole in it.
All right, what are we waiting on?
He's going to the bathroom real quick, but so you use your alchemist fire and light up some wet wood, and it takes you a little while, but you do dry it enough to get a fire started. So I suppose let's do watches.
First watch.
Second, Tanner's third. And I believe fourth is Ryan, and then Dahl is the last one.
Yep.
Okay, very good.
Do we want to roll his perception for him? Because I don't think he has that button.
Who?
Dahl.
I do. I'm opening the thing up right now. I had to restart my tablet.
So, Darp, you don't watch Rick and Morty?
No, I don't really have a whole lot of time for TV shows.
And yet you're going to try to show Zoo, old Greg, and the rest of fucking the Mighty Boots.
I mean, just the skits, really. They're not that long.
Yeah, that's like 5 minutes, or 15 minutes just to watch all three if you wanted to.
Fucking, I love the one where, like, he spray paints on the front of the store, Howard Moon licks balls for money, and the transvestite walks in like, hello, cowboy. Like, all the way up to
spoilers, man.
Sounds entertaining.
It's a hilarious show.
Run away.
There's an episode.
Sorry, go ahead. I realized that Darp is probably preparing.
There's another episode where, like, they meet a living sandstorm. He's like, I'm the Sandman. And, like, he's like, I can't even hug anyone. I can't even touch myself. Everything I touch gets sanded down to a fine veneer.
Reminds me of the Skittles commercial where everything you touch turns into Skittles.
I thought you were about to say the one where he comes Skittles. Did you ever see that one? It was supposed to be... What was that, Dahl?
I said, oh yeah, that Skittles commercial.
Yeah, no, that was actually, I think, during one of the Super Bowls. Like, it's like a husband and wife, like, consummating their marriage, and he goes, here comes the sweetness, and then the Skittles hits her face.
Yeah, that was a fake commercial, though.
Oh, it was?
Yeah, but it was funny.
Pretty good.
I don't think that Skittles would do that.
No.
Come on,
that's corporate suicide.
Nonsense. Think of all the adults who'd buy Skittles just for the sweetness. In my world, I'd like to believe that could be on television.
You're breaking up.
Actually,
oh, so I'm back.
Ray.
Anything happened?
I'm looking right now.
I'm gonna be our.
Okay.
Well, we'll wait for him to come back. Yeah, Darp, when you ever get a chance, I'm sure you could find him online, because I don't think they're on any streaming service yet, aside from online sites, but, like, if you started watching Rick and Morty, I have the feeling you'd fall in love with it, because it is goddamn hilarious. Possibly, like, one of the best things to come out of Adult Swim in just years.
What about Adventure Time? I know that was a big thing.
That's not Adult Swim. I love Adventure Time. I'm just saying, like, Adult Swim hasn't really had a really good program in, like, a good long while, except for, like, China, Illinois, I love.
Mm.
Adventure Time also went off the rails.
It did recently, yeah. They've gotten really serious in the past few.
Well, it stopped focusing on Finn and Jake and started doing every other episode, like, a one-off episode. Or if you do see him again, it's in, like, a very limited capacity.
Yeah.
Like, not as good.
Well, I mean, the guy who made it, he's a D&D nerd. I think that's why I liked it originally, because there's just a whole bunch of stuff that was like...
Okay.
That's why I liked it, too.
Now that we have everyone back, I think we're just going to say that nothing happens, actually, because the roll was close enough.
Nice.
Excellent job, team.
So.
Is it still raining the next morning when we
wake up? It actually is still raining when you wake up.
Hate this place. I mean, at least my feathers are waterproof, but doesn't mean I have to like rain.
I'm going to cast Read Weather.
Is that a spell?
Yep.
Sexy.
Way to go, Channel 5.
Basically, that's exactly what it is. Spell allows you to forecast the weather at your location. Aw, it's only at my location. That might not be so good.
Well, the weather doesn't differ that much. Right? I mean...
Yeah. I mean, we're only traveling...
If you forecast it in one town, and a town is 50 miles over, it's probably going to be pretty similar.
Yeah, you're right. Especially since it's grasslands and there's no mountains or anything.
Yeah.
Anyways, it allows me to know the weather for the next 48 hours. With advance warning of storms, tornadoes, so on, forecast reveals only the weather that would arise. Naturally, does not take into account magical occurrences. That
right, that makes sense. Because you
Should
can't
I hold
predict
that
other people's
under
intent.
Him as he talks?
Can you do what?
He means, like, why there's a green screen up. Can he hold that disclaimer?
Like, predictions may not include magical or otherwise. Like, weather changes.
Cannot be responsible for magical intent.
Yeah, there you go.
Okay, so... Elethyss gets up and, you know, he does his meditation thing and gets all his spells ready for the day. And, we just lost cycle out of roll 20.
Uh-oh.
I'm here. It's just my roll 20 is dependent on, like, the browser.
Yeah.
Like, my tablet keeps going to sleep.
Oh, that's fine.
Or not going to sleep, it just, like, blinks out.
Yeah. Okay.
So if I tab over, it just completely closes. So it just shuts down my Google Chrome. That's what it's doing.
No, that's fine. God. As long as you can pop okay, back in, it doesn't matter.
Mm-hmm.
So Elethyss gets up and steps up outside the wagon and just sort of stares at the sky for, like,
a minute.
Is it a minute?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
What a
turkey. He says some rather interesting incantations.
And I whack some sticks together.
Moves, yeah, wax, okay, yeah, sure, whack some sticks together.
Well, no, like, that's part of the thing. I have to have a set of mark sticks.
I love that. I love it.
Oh my god.
Smacking sticks together, saying a weird spell, and staring at the sky.
Oh, and it actually has a material component with a gold cost.
Yeah.
So you need to have 25 gold set aside to buy those sticks.
Which I think that would be reasonable.
Yeah. I mean, I don't think they get consumed.
I doubt
that. That seems unreasonable.
I think I would just have the sticks and
yeah.
It would cost me 25 gold.
Yep, that works for me. Okay, I haven't seen a spell that actually has a cost yet, so that's fun. So you whack your sticks together and wave them around funny, and you're able to predict that it's probably going to thunderstorm for the majority of the day. You can expect lightning, probably higher winds towards the afternoon / evening, and you're not so sure that it's going to let up tomorrow either.
So that's you saying that it's not going to let up tomorrow, because I know it for the next 48 hours.
Okay, yes. Yes. Well, I guess I assumed that your 48 hours from now would be less accurate than your predictions for today. I guess I was thinking meteorologically, though, and not magically. So,
I'm doing a magic rain dance. I know the
yeah.
Elethyss, you look over to see me looking at you like this.
The judging face. Okay, so you know it's going to thunderstorm and or rain for the next 2 days, off and on. There may be hail tomorrow. And, well, actually, I guess maybe isn't fair, because you just straight up know the fucking weather.
Yeah, like the fact that my spells give me pure fucking knowledge of everything.
Yeah, it's so stupid. All right. So today it's going to rain, and then tonight it's going to thunderstorm with high winds, and overnight there will be hail. First thing in the morning tomorrow, you'll
got
have
a cold front coming in from the south.
That's right.
Might get a little bit of hail from that.
Chance of Etheria up from the east.
The next morning, it's going to get
Etherian winds are coming down.
Jesus. The next morning, it's going to lighten up and just be kind of some sprinkles. After that, the winds will pick up again, and there will be another thunderstorm, but not near as fierce as tonight.
This place sucks.
Relay the fact that we're looking at some rough roads ahead, and we might want to keep an eye out for, like, good places to find shelter as we travel along the road today.
El Nino is coming.
Gravel
There's going to be some really rough hail later today and some winds and thunderstorms, so we don't want to get, like, stuck in a bad spot. So along our travels, we might want to stop early today.
Why not just warp wood around the covered wagon's canvas, or at least on the inside, and then just kind of wrap it around the structure so that way we have a hard surface above us that we can sleep under? It'd be loud as shit, but at least we're not getting hit in the face with hail.
You are right about that.
It would be loud as shit.
I mean, we could just
We should still look for, like, a good place to have shelter if we could find one, but worst comes to worst, we can shape some wood in a way that will at least be safe.
I'm gonna collect wood before we go, just for that, so it can dry off inside of the wagon.
That's a good idea.
And Darp, don't be that guy who pokes a hole in the wagon's canvas above the wood. Like one hailstorm.
It's not my fault that you tried his Viagra pill, okay?
Oh my.
Got him.
Ha! Got him!
So how am I feeling, Darp?
You feel about the same as yesterday, actually. It gives you kind of a sense of security.
Not about security. Reasonable apprehension. No, cautious optimism. There we go.
Wow. Okay. So, Okay, so we're moving along.
Yes.
I'm going to do a survival check and see if there might be a place that provides more shelter along our way.
An excellent plan.
Anything.
That is kind of your forte. So, yeah, well, so you're looking for things like cave mouths or...
Cave mouths or, like,
tight forest. Groupings of trees.
Yeah.
Okay. Probably about 20 miles into your journey, you find a cluster of trees that are a little tighter than what you've seen in the forest so far. The forest is a little thicker. On the southeast side of the road.
Wait, you said how many miles down the road?
20 or so. So okay. Pretty close to where you expect the dirt path to be.
Isn't the dirt path like 15 miles down the road from us?
I thought it was closer to 22 when I saw you measure it earlier. Yeah, it's pretty close to 20.
Okay, cool. So we find a tight grouping of trees.
Yep. Yep.
Awesome. Shit, I just had this felt pulled up. Give me a sec. Basically allows me to have plants help us.
Are you gonna make them weave a mesh to catch the hail?
Uh-huh.
Awesome.
Elethyss is like, I love and respect nature because I make it work for me.
I guess the real question is, how well does the party believe you in your weather predicting?
I, for one, do not trust weather wizards.
I'm going to point out that weather is my domain. Like, it literally is my specialty as a druid.
All weather wizards say that. Next thing you know, you're at the beach thinking it's going to be a nice sunshiny day, and some other wizard comes along and throws out a rain spell just to rain on everyone else's happiness.
Okay, so this spell actually doesn't do what I thought it did, so I would just have to reshape trees. The spell is forest friend, and it's like, it makes the plants helpful to you, but really that means that they just don't get in your way.
Oh, they don't impede your movement, it's like a jungle type thing.
Yeah. There's another one, command plants, that would allow me to tell the trees what to fucking do, but... I will instead suggest that we camp here instead of traveling the rest of our time. Since there's trees nearby that I can shape to provide some covering from the thunderstorm that is probably still going on, like we've been experiencing wind and stuff, so. Will the party heed my advice is the question. Or will they remain perfectly silent?
I'll listen to you. I think you know what you're talking about. I trust you.
He's talking about... Oh, what? I trust. I also trust. Why? He hasn't said anything that I shouldn't trust him about. He hasn't deceived and been rude, like some people.
Sense motive on weather.
Since, you know, I cast a spell and fully believe what I'm saying, it would be...
Plus, whatever the weather is, I'm not too... we're all going to be affected by it.
Yeah, we'll figure it out pretty soon.
Okay, Well, I guess we stop for the night, and I go into the, you know, group of trees, and on a few of them, I cast Wood Shape to cause them, their branches to make a nice little, for more or less, like a hut under the trees.
Okay. It's like a forced canopy.
Yeah. And since the winds are picking up, I try to tie everything down with the rope that Kirrik has.
Alright, that'll be strength check for the rope tying.
I ask some of my stronger friends to tie.
I will assist. The rope.
Or
I'm gonna pull just...
Get a nat fucking 20 again.
Or you should just tie it yourself, because I'm weak as shit.
Alright.
I will assist you in tying
it. It's loading.
Slash cool. Flex, I'll try.
I am assisting Zuzu in tying. God damn it.
Okay, it's in skills?
It's in core.
Okay.
And it is actually quite dark now.
I cast light on the wagon.
Oof.
On the wagon.
Probably should hide campsite first.
Yeah, well, I had campsite after I've made the force canopy and we're tying stuff down. And I do cast light on the wagon just in case it blows away so we can see it.
That hey, shouldn't be playing.
With us.
Here we go. It's fixed. Yes. I think
Cold
that's everybody.
Lit.
Okay.
And
can everyone see that?
I can.
Okay. Whoa. My roll 20 froze, I think. Okay, there we go. I don't think it's happy with me having two instances open.
It might not be very happy with you.
Alright, there we go. The Zavrik, of course, can just see everything because he can see in the dark because he's a bastard.
Make it sound like a bad thing.
It is. It's my life difficult.
Where's our fire? Didn't we have a thing for fire?
This is a different night. You don't have a fire yet.
Well, didn't we save some wood in the back of the wagon so we could easily light a fire?
Did you say that you did? Because I don't remember.
Kirrik did.
Oh, he did?
Yeah, I was collecting firewood to dry out in the wagon as we went.
Oh, yeah!
And that's when you made the penis joke.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah! I remember now.
See,
clever.
People are listening.
Clever girl.
Ah, misc tokens found it. There we go. I almost dragged out every single token
for attention
that we have.
That would have been bad. Campfire!
Campfire
wow,
lights
like,
up way more
everything.
Than the light.
That's awesome.
Good thing Hyde Campsite is making sure that doesn't go farther than that.
Yes.
Of course, we are under a dense underbrush of trees. Things might... Well, of course, I guess I wouldn't know this.
Nope.
Never mind.
No, you would not.
The druid might wink.
Hey, I'm repairing a lot of stuff right now. I've lit a fire using wood that you collected. I've melded trees together to form a canopy. I put a light on the wagon just in case it gets blown off in the distance during the night. I've been busy.
Yeah.
I'm working on things.
I search for animal tracks. I search for animal tracks under the trees.
I say while smoking a cigarette.
It's kind of... muddy slash grassy here now. Well, not that it's just recently grassy. It's always been grassy, and now it's muddy. Okay.
What the hell? Grass appeared overnight.
Fuck.
Oh no, I've heard of this spontaneous grass.
It eats men alive. I like it that you're like the fake bard character. Like, you say...
Exactly.
Morky's gonna get cold.
Yeah, bring Morky into the campsite.
Wait, can I do a dual class in Pathfinder?
Yeah.
I didn't hear that.
Yeah, yes. You can, totally.
Oh, shit.
It just slows down your progression on your main class.
Oh, okay.
Do I find that, Darp?
Because, like, you're level 6 alchemist, and if you took bard next level, then you'd be a 6/1 alchemist slash bard.
Gotcha, okay. That could definitely be worth exploring.
An alchabard. Or a bardamist.
It'd be interesting because your charisma was already pretty low, and that's their main stat. So I'm not sure how well that would go.
Right, that is my dump stat.
Maybe something more like wizard would be interesting? Or sorcerer?
Yeah, I hadn't thought about that.
Doesn't he have to take wild magic for that?
No.
Oh, right, because he has a magical class. Never mind, he's a caster.
Anyway, after setting up the campsite and making sure everything is prepared, also, since Cycle is on a tablet, do you mind moving Monkey into the campsite, Darp?
Fair enough.
Yeah, Darp, when I looked for footprints, did I find that on the ground?
Find what on the ground?
I sent it to you in a tell. Like, I don't think we should stay here.
Oh, Jurassic Park shakes.
The fucking the big, like, T-Rex, like, footprint. We're, like, camping in it. Yeah.
Like... So. At this point of the evening, you look for your footprints, and you don't really find any because it's really wet now, and any recent tracks would have probably washed away hours ago. If not yesterday. Because it's been raining nonstop. And probably sometime around 11, when you are beginning to sleep, you hear the hail start, which I don't have a sound for, but you hear a loud cacophony of things hitting the wood above you. Which I suppose I could look up a sound. Just for...
Anyways, but I mean, before we go to sleep, I am going to cast Wild Instinct since there's going to be lots of sounds. Which increases my perception.
You're doing what now?
Casting Wild Instinct before we go to sleep. I become aware of sounds and smells I would normally overlook. I obtain the ability to detect threats when soundly asleep for the duration of the spell, 8 hours. And get a +5 bonus on perception checks to act in a surprise round. Initially, I don't take a penalty on perception checks while sleeping, and I can choose to wake if I notice a threat while asleep.
That's awesome.
What's the name of the spell again?
Wild Instinct.
I'm gonna get real familiar with druid spells this game. I tell you that.
You and me both. I will tell you later something that I just found out about druid spells, but I don't want to say it out loud.
Aware of sounds and smells you'd normally overlook. Wow.
I've used it once before.
That's pretty slick. I like that. Alright. So. Let me see how much damage the hail does.
What?
Our roof? Yeah.
We got golf ball sized hail?
Yeah, it's, well, is, are you looking at the hail?
I'd imagine I could hear it.
Yeah, but landing around your campsite, are you just trying to, like, fall asleep? Or are you looking around observing the hail? Because I'll tell you if you want to know.
No, I'll fucking, hold on.
Kirrik's going to inspect the hail.
Hide under the covers.
I don't think the hail cares whether or not you hide from it.
It's quiet, it's quiet under there. Quieter.
So you can do six.
Hiding in bedroll.
Per spell. How many of those did you cast?
How many of what did I cast?
Wood shape.
Three wood shapes.
Okay. That's quite a bit of wood.
Yeah. Well, I figured there were several trees, and it would make a good shelter.
So I'm going to say that it hails for 2 hours.
Oh, that's annoying.
It's a very long hailstorm. And your wood canopy survives the onslaught.
Awesome job.
Yay.
And during the night, who is on?
I have first watch.
Second watch.
Who is on the last watch?
It would be Dull. He wakes up with Folgers to get extra perception.
And I'm asleep, but I have a bonus to my perception, so I'm just gonna roll mine anyway.
That's fair.
It's plus 5, so 33.
I'm coming in.
Okay. The hail subsides, but the rain and the wind are still pretty hardcore. Your rope does seem to hold. And I guess my question would be, what did you tie the wagon to? Is the rope reaching outside of the hide campsite business?
Wouldn't it be tied to the trees that he
I'm pretty sure
the tree in the center.
Probably one of the trees. If we need to like slightly rearrange where our bodies are so that works better, we could probably do that. But I would assume that we'd put the wagon next to a tree and tie it to it.
Okay.
Because if the trees get uprooted, then we're all screwed.
There's my perception.
Wow, those are some unimpressive strength rolls, aren't they?
Yep. We were helping Zanthem when we were doing. She was on tying rope.
Cichael, you hear kind of like a low growling sound coming from the west side of the campsite.
Oh shit.
It sounds a bit like a cat.
Cat.
Well, I'm gonna knowledge nature that.
It's a good guess.
I'm like, my buddy Elvis would roll knowledge nature. I'm gonna fucking roll it, yeah.
Okay. You actually don't think this creature is natural. You suspect it might be magical in nature.
Okay. I think this would be an Arcana roll.
Yep.
Yep.
Fuck yeah.
Wow. Even with the not being able to see it penalty, like, that's a solid roll.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, 16 to knowledge arcana.
You think that sounds a bit like a Serpopard.
Serpopard?
Fairly certain you also know what a Serpopard is.
Yes.
This magical creature which I know a lot about.
but can't describe in detail.
Wait, is that a fucking tiger snake?
Yeah, basically. Oh, they're an ancient Egyptian creature, actually, is what they're based on. This one looks a bit like a leopard with a long neck. Like a very long serpentine sort of neck.
That's not how I was picturing it at all. I was picturing it the other way.
Like nope.
Snake with a cat head.
Let me actually... Well,
I'm gonna immediately wake up. Just more key and run. Fuck you guys.
Oh, he's so pretty looking.
I wake you all up. But quietly.
We should.
It's a fucking Serpopard.
We should make it into a pet.
Actually, I think I'll wake up Elethyss first and explain to him. But this is a magical, and I say, there's a Serpopard coming. It looks kind of like a fucked up animal, but it's not natural. It's magical. Be careful.
Elethyss wakes up and says, kill it!
God
damn it.
Probably wouldn't try to tame a magical creature. I'm gonna point out that I'm not on good terms with them generally. We should probably make up Sabrick.
I guess
Sabrick
you would know it's
you
not
should kill
natural,
it like a hunter's
yeah.
blind again.
I would know.
The other thing, actually, I should tell you a lot more about this creature, huh? You know that they can see in the dark, like they can see at night. They are very fierce. You wouldn't want to get into a melee tussle with one, because they have. Strong what? Bite and claws.
You know, so be a caster.
You know that they have a pretty limber neck, obviously. Let's see, what does that do? You know that they can use their long neck to make bite attacks as part of a rake attack against grappled opponents. Oh wow, he can grapple people with his fucking neck. And then bite them. That is weird. You also know that they have the ability to leap.
Leap?
Oh, yeah, like jump at you. Yeah. And that if they're in a desert climate, which this one clearly isn't, so that's not relevant. We'll ignore that. You know they're more commonly found in, like, plains regions or deserts, so it's a bit weird that this one's here.
I wake up our monster hunter friend after Psycho wakes me up, and I'm like, I think we should see if Zagfrick has ever fought any of these before, because that is one fucked up cat.
I would assume since our place is surrounded by plains that I've probably encountered them before, but
to the west, yes.
Doubt that I've ever don't know that I've fought one. I might be, you know, I might have heard of them, but I don't know much about them.
Very well. Do you think we should fight it? Or just try to avoid it.
Surprise attack it.
When in doubt, kill it with fire.
Kill everything.
Very well. I have a bonus to perception, and me and Cycle have this awesome feat that allows us to have a better chance to take part in surprise round.
It's true.
Oh, shit.
When
yeah,
we have
true.
The bonus. So, let's... do you want to kill it, Cycle?
Knowing as much about it as I do, I don't think we should get into a fight with it if we can help it. If we do, we should really try to burst it down immediately. I have my bombs. Do I know what kind of, like, resistances this might have?
Defenses. You know they've got a thick hide. And they're pretty beefy creatures, but beyond that, they don't have any, like, magical resistances that you know of.
Gotcha.
Very well. Well, okay. It's kind of raining out. I can use that to our advantage, and if you want to throw some bombs, let's do this.
Raining and windy, yes.
What's raining and windy do, like, for attack rolls, like range attack?
Who's got two thumbs and not going to get within 30 feet of that fucking thing? This guy.
one second.
Sorry, I can't really look up stuff because it would...
Yep, that's fair.
Hey, it's cumbersome. Yeah.
Yep. So this would count as a thunderstorm. Right? Yeah.
That is what you said.
Rain reduces visibility ranges by half, resulting in a -4 penalty on perception checks. Has the same effect on flames, ranged weapon attacks, and... Oh, wow. Flames, ranged weapon attacks, and perception checks as severe wind. Oh. So there's a separate thing for severe wind. Where is that? Let's see. This is probably going to be... strong wind. You are all medium creatures... So you take -2 on ranged attacks. There is no snow.
Well,
you fortunately don't have to deal with hail.
Well, I think we should all be ready for a throwdown, and if we're going to burst it, if we're going to try to range burst it, it's you, me, and Zanthem that are going to have to unload on this all at once. Right now, we don't even see it. We don't even know where it is.
That is true.
Right.
And I'm going to alter the campfire right quick, because you can't see that far, actually.
We could possibly, you guys included, roll perception and see if you can... see if we can figure out where it is.
Oh, well, we can still see it. Or at least... I can.
People with dark vision or low light can, yeah.
Okay.
Well, now I can't see it, so he took away my privileges.
I tell Cycle that if it's within my sight range, so if you can't see it, maybe you should change yourself to a creature that can.
Well, that's a good point. Fuck, I can't even look at, like, my extracts.
Do we know if it's even approaching us? So why do we...
It's roaming around right now.
So it's like the Hydra, but
it's
going...
wandering a bit.
Hmm.
Aimlessly.
Kind of growling a little. No, it's not purring. It's not purring. Yes, that's much closer.
Like, how many hours are we?
I can alter myself to... I don't know what would be a good thing to do.
A cat.
Or even just low light.
That sounds
turn
great.
Yourself into an elf. Like, that'll work too.
Yeah, I'll give myself dark vision. I'll do that.
Okay, 1 second. I'll make that alteration. Alteration done.
There it is. God damn, that thing is gross.
It's kind of nasty. It also seems to be approaching us now. Shall we do this?
Yeah, well, is it
can
moving?
You position yourself?
It looks like
by.
It's kind of moving past us. Actually recommend that we're hidden, right?
Yeah.
Yep. Yes.
I would recommend we not engage this thing. Oh, okay. Unless, do you think we need to get
actually,
it to
actually, how many hours does Hide Campsite
hunting?
Last?
What was that?
How many hours does Hide Campsite last?
12 hours.
2 hours per level? Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Never mind.
Yeah.
Sorry to interrupt. Go ahead.
No problem.
That's okay. Yeah, I don't
can you
think
if we, can murder us?
We can murder it. Doesn't sound like to me. What do you guys think? I mean, I've shared all my information with you.
Is it kind of suspicious that this creature is here? Or do you think if we kill it,
we learn something from it? We encounter strange creatures in the night all the time. Fire luck.
We encountered a hydra last time.
Yeah. Plus, we got a surprise round, so that's like a free round, right? We
possibly have a spike.
Yeah, but to be fair, the hydra is kind of expected to be in a swampy area. This is a desert creature.
Yeah.
Desert and plains creature, and we're near the plains.
Do you have strong burst, Walker? Range burst?
I have only my storm burst, which is like lightning.
I guess you are bordering the plains. Yeah, you're on the road next to it.
What would be the pros or cons of killing the creature? Like, what do we gain from it if we kill it?
More stuff to give with the... Well, XP.
Oh, XP. Yeah,
XP and possibly the hide, which we could maybe use for something. You know what, let's fuck it. Let's do it. Let's kill it.
I would say if you took down a beast like this, you'd definitely prove yourselves to the Reisenjager.
Oh,
awesome.
I think we do it.
Kind of close. But what about the hydra? Actually probably throw bombs, get our surprise round, and he won't be able to see us.
Can I position so that you guys are behind me, just as a meat shield?
Sure.
Well, you don't want to be close to this ever, so you probably shouldn't be in front of us anyway.
Well, I mean, if it's going to attack somebody, might as well hit somebody with a lot of hit points.
Yeah, and higher likelihood of dodging the attacks. I seem to recall that in our last melee, you were the only one that didn't get shit owned.
Okay, I'll swap with Savrik and let him kind of sneak in front of me, and then Kirrik has the ability to move through me at will in combat. So really
don't worry, I'm not. It doesn't really matter. I'm not gonna try that because I know I'm gonna walk by it and get knocked out again.
grappled and bitten by the snake neck.
I definitely set my glaive aside and grabbed the sword.
I don't need venom too. Oh, it rolled a perfect 20. Fantastic.
Anyway,
that's not perfect 20. What do you think, it has zero initiative?
These are the initiative rolls, but so for I'm curious about like how the surprise round would work, like if we were casting a spell from our hide campsite.
Hold on, my roll 20 is lagging up.
No
problem. Hey, Severk, how impressive was it that we killed the hydra? Would they be impressed with that too, or no?
They're pretty impressed. They'd be pretty impressed by that. I'll refrain telling them about you shooting me in the ass as well. But
I appreciate that. Awesome.
That's very sweet.
It's because he liked it.
Where's the initiative? I can't find it on my character sheet.
It'd be on the front page, I think.
I can't look at that one at all. I'm talking about, like, in Roll 20.
Yeah, I know. That's what I meant, in Roll 20, the core tab. There's also just the button on your token, but I guess you can't see your token, so...
I can roll it for you. For some reason, I can't even select... I can't even select my... The problem is that all of the graphics and overlays and menus are all the normal size, but the screen size doesn't change, so I can see a sliver of the actual map, and that's it. But the buttons go underneath all of the other windows. So, like, at this point, the initiative window is taking up about 40% of my visible screen.
Shit.
Which is fine, but it just blocks my ability to, like, hit buttons and shit. I can't find initiative. I see int.
I'm going to reload my roll 20, and then I can roll it for you.
That would be swell.
Oh my god, immediately better. Okay. Here we go. Initiative for you. 17. Okay, so, in a surprise round, you would all technically get one move or attack. You get one action before it gets attacked, so it is after all of you.
Okay. Would it be confused by the fact that it can't see where the attacks are coming from?
Probably not. I mean, it would be confused, but it would probably just either run away or charge in the general direction of where it got hit from.
Okay. That answers that question. In that case, shall we begin attacks?
Yeah, no special arrows, right? Or should I just use the durable arrows?
So you assumed like that you got all of your, well...
stuff crafted.
Remember that his stuff, like Cycle was saying, or Darby was saying on behalf of Cycle, that he's got, like, thick skin, mm-hmm. but no magical or any type of resistances. So, you would assume that he has thick skin.
Okay. Well, I'll just use my regular arrows then. Okay, so if it's with the wind and rain, I take it's a minus two.
Correct.
Got a little beepy problem with your mic there.
Who?
You do.
You do.
Yeah, it's acting a little funny.
Okay, let's see. Well, I can't see the creature, so I guess I'm gonna have to hold until I can see the creature, because my vision isn't as good as everyone else's. So what do I do with that?
Not.
Hold it?
You can hold it.
But we're
then it would be Cycle's turn.
Yep.
Okay. I want to double... I want to do a... What is it? A rapid shot? God damn it, my buttons are disappearing. For some reason, I don't see that macro on my list. I have single bomb. I don't see... What the fuck... I want to do a rapid shot and throw two bombs.
All right, can we hear me? Oh my god, that was bizarro world. Okay. Try to fix the beep and shit. All right, so we throw a bomb at a 22 to hit. And the creature is flat-footed to you. And actually, it'll be a 20 to hit, won't it? Because rain. Okay, yeah. All right. Flat-footed AC. All right, so you throw a bomb, and you hit. But attacks is all happening at the same time. So we'll talk about what you observe after you throw everything. Fair? Elethyss. Stormburst. Maybe. It's against... It's... Please do. All right, Saverick. Do you... Yeah. Actually, let me check that you can. You can charge, but I don't think you can hit. No, you can only hit once. Anytime you charge, you'll only be able to hit once. Okay. You would have to do it as a charge, actually, because it's a surprise round and you only get one action. Does that make sense? So you're charging him and attacking in the same action, I think. Yeah, well, we just use the 23 and the 11. Kirrik, do you have any plans to do anything? You could roll a stealth since you're totally concealed right now, too. I have no problem with that. Ah, damn. All right. So, the absolute onslaught. Zanthem complains that she is unable to see the creature and doesn't understand how, as the archer, she isn't able to see as well as the rest of her party. It seems odd. It bothers you a little. And you get, yeah. Yeah, you can go ahead and take a move if you'd like. As part of the surprise round. Yeah. So, Cichael throws a bomb. Elethyss hits it with a storm burst. Well, he tries to hit it with a storm burst. I guess I haven't answered whether or not that hits yet. I need to find out what its touch flat footed AC is because it's both. Okay. Oh, yeah. He gets that pretty soon, I think. Okay, so Cichael throws a bomb. Elethyss shoots lightning beams out of his hands. Or wait, no, Stormburst is actually wind and rain, isn't it? So Elethyss actually manipulates the wind and the rain that's currently happening, and it you see it kind of move through the air, sort of like an invisible force pushed it into the cat. At the same time as Cichael's bomb hits this thing, fire erupts and like coalesces over its fur, and it shrieks in pain. And then Severick is just, like, charging past all this shit to hit it in the face. Jesus. Let me add up all this damage. Let me try to get this damage accounted for. Okay, so 19. Yeah, he does get an action. Yeah, absolutely. So he could pull one out in surprise round completely. Oh, nice. In the future, oh, fair enough. Yeah, that's fair. Okay, never mind. Unhelpful hints with Darpe, 2015. Yeah. Yep. Now take that and multiply it by 4, and that's DMing. the levels of scatterbrain that I reach. It's pretty crazy. Alright, so it is the cat's turn now. No longer in surprise round. Her. It's a magical beast, so probably not. It might, but it would probably have a huge DC. Okay, Sabrik, what's your AC minus 2? Okay. Okay. Then you get hit by all three of those, then. It's really not that bad. He used to be an adventurer like you, and then he took an arrow to the butt cheek. So it just, when you charge it and slice at it, it rears up on its hind legs and just, like, scratches at you and bites for your neck. Ends up biting your shoulder instead and tearing a small piece out. Serpopard. What's this bomb throw for? Accidental, I assume. Zanthem. You're gonna fire blindly at that square? Okay. That works. Yeah, you can partly see it. It's kind of faded in the darkness, but you can sort of make it out. So I would say partial concealment, so 20% chance to miss. Actually, even if she moves, the light source is stationary. It's the yeah. Fuck the tree. Pull it out of the ground. Yeah. Wait, what? Yeah. Yeah, he took 15, 21, yeah. 16, 22. Yeah, I'm math. Oh, because you moved. Okay, cool. Well, actually, you can't do many shot and move. So your many shot arrows. Yeah. Not. You can use it today if you'd like. Moving won't affect you, but if you stand still and shoot, then you're fine. Oh, I have record of what happened. 1 second. Your longsword is actually flaming. So roll me a d6 for the flaming damage. Nice. And Zanthem. She can make out, she can partly make out the creature, but not completely. I'm just going to roll these in public. Okay, this will be attack 1 and attack 2. And it looks like they both hit. So, that's a lot of damage. Okay, so Zanthem pelts this thing full of freaking arrows, and it has just got so much blood pouring out of it now that it wails in pain. Cycle. Savrik, you know that the creature is near death. A lot. Yep. No, one of them rolled one because it's 3d6s. No, it doesn't. No. Yep, we learned this a while ago. We've been playing it wrong forever. That's true. So your two bombs hit, and this thing. Wow, okay. Let me math. Wow, okay. So yeah, there's just nothing left of this thing. It's just a pile of ash. I mean skeleton, perhaps. But like the hide is burned beyond recognition, the flesh is charred and shriveled and black. It's basically just like burnt corpse. This is flavor. Good night, man. Oh, fair enough. Have a good night at work. Yeah, that's pretty accurate. But oh, he missed that joke, I think. That's sad. Well, yeah, but it's got like thick, like black, leathery flesh covering the skull. It's like, it's really gross looking. Yeah, it's. Yep, the trophy. Okay. You...
Savrik did well.
Savrik very carefully inspects the corpse and removes all of the bones and body parts that he believes are of value. But beyond that, you don't find any items on its person, for lack of a better word.
On its snakiness. Creature?
It's almost corpse, because it's not really there.
Yeah.
It's remains.
There you go.
Yeah, you don't find any items on its remains. That is a good way to
I want to high-five Zanthem and say, listen, when I was kind of whiff-waffling earlier about our ability to kill this thing, I wasn't really taking into account our ginormous ability to fucking destroy, crush shit.
Mm-hmm. I smile and give you a high five back.
I do it, but then I take the skull and I aim it at Zanthem again and flap the jaw and say, hey Zanthem, thanks for helping Cichael murder the shit out of me like you did with all them arrows.
I just glare at you.
What?
Rude.
Okay, so if it's the next day, I'm going to cast Restore Flesh on the skull and other parts that...
What?
Actually, it's the morning. Shit, fuck it, dog. I can do it to the whole creature. Boom. It's got flesh again.
Ooh, that's awesome.
What?
Brand new pelt.
Oh, that's some dope shit. I wonder if I could craft like a... what do you call it? Like a bottle of formaldehyde. Like a jar of formaldehyde.
So are you talking about restore corpse?
Yes, restore corpse. You grow flesh on a decomposed or skeletonized corpse of a medium or smaller creature, providing it with sufficient flesh that it can be animated as a zombie rather than a skeleton. This corpse looks as it did when the creature died.
Oh, dude, that's awesome.
The flesh is somewhat rotted and not fit for eating.
Okay. So it is. It does look a little like it's been laying here a while.
Yeah, less like a burned crisp and more like a decayed monster.
Fascinating. Okay.
I think I rolled the right one for high five, though. Right?
Combat maneuver, definitely.
Yes. High five me back. Not bad.
I didn't watch the elbow. But I think we pretty much nailed it.
Yeah, you did.
Mm-hmm.
So, you collect your trophy. And if you'd like, we can call it here.
It's probably for the best.
Since it's 15 till anyway.